This is a new studio. This is a modern studio. This is a state-of-the-art studio. It's also an Atmos studio in an old building, but in the context of what I would call a retro feeling and spirit. We're in Paris. I'm in Paris for the first time in 8 years, which is a little strange since for the last 2.5 years, I and my team have been designing the very studio you're seeing in the backdrop. We got the call from Max and Victor. Actually, it was Eddie Kramer who recommended that we take over this project. Eddie has changed my life at Electric Lady Studios, so he's a lifetime friend and we've done projects together. The basic layout of this floor already mostly was in existence, and we also even inherited a little bit of a design. Threw that away, went back to square one, and basically tested the room shapes and the room geometries specifically for low frequency. The timing couldn't have been better because over the last 3 or 4 years, we've been using a lot of different tools for low frequency analysis. So basically that means everything below the Schroeder frequency, which to make it translated into English means everything sort of below 200 and 300 hertz, which is really the difficult part of recording studio design. Everything above the Schroeder frequency, which is reflection control, is much easier to handle because sound kind of behaves like lines, looks like pool balls bouncing around on a pool table, and it's much easier to conceive. But below Schroeder is much harder. And we've been using tools ranging from intuition to spreadsheets, formulas, histograms, some software, ABEC in particular was one that we were using, and started to find out that these were not working as well for us as we thought that they could. And on our own, started developing our own software. This sort of led to a research project, and that software is called NIRO, which actually stands for non-cuboid iterative room optimization, because most of our rooms end up not being completely rectangular. That software confirmed the viability, particularly of this room, that its shape was going to at least allow us to produce a world-class control room, which was the goal.
This room is everything in one. It sounds amazing. It looks amazing. It feels like home. It feels like heaven. There's so many wonderful aesthetics and feel to the room, but it also sounds amazing.
By the way, we couldn't move things very much. Why? Because as I'm sure by now you've noticed, this entire console goes down on an elevator lift because this room needs to do other things. Okay, needs to become an event room or a teaching room, et cetera, et cetera. So this entire console has to go down, so it couldn't move too much.
It gave us the opportunity to do a couple really interesting things. One of the things is that we have this big hole in the front of the speakers that if the console is up, the hole is empty. What we started realizing very early on is that we can use this as a low frequency trap. So the perforations that you see here on the left side, so all those perforations, they actually make this hole act as a low frequency absorber, which is really advantageous because it takes the first bounce of the subwoofer, the SBIR effect of the subwoofer. It basically, for the low frequency, it makes the floor disappear.
As we tour the room and you see different treatments, either perforated wood or slotted wood, okay, or wood with holes in it. These are basically resonators or pressure absorbers designed to obtain the optimized frequency response in the listening position. Well, the B room, I think visually the glass is what makes the room kind of magical and nice and sweet. And maybe there's 4 A's. Now that I think about it, maybe there's acoustics, there's architecture, there's audio, and then there's art. Because then there's always that moment where everybody agrees on everything you said, and we're still going to do it this way. Because the view is amazing. I want to look out the window. Remember, I went to architecture school, so architecture is full-scale human sculpture. It took a while to get, and I think it has to do with Max and Victor's image of what goes on in this room, of the engineers that are coming into this room. So it was important to get this combined aesthetic of something that's new and modern and contemporary, okay, but also has respect for vintage moments.